Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create your own custom front page of the New York Times in color. I provided a template so you can follow along. It includes the newspaper base, all the necessary fonts, which are already positioned in place for your headline, secondary headline, date, text for your photo, as well as the shape that your photo will be placed into, so there's no guesswork. The links to the template and fonts are in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, smash that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a color photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. We'll place it onto the template. If your Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard and drag the photo onto the tab of the template. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. We'll resize and reposition it, but first, open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the Alpha 1 thumbnail to select its shape. Open back your Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your photo. Click the Chain Link icon to unlink the photo with the layer mask. This will allow us to resize and reposition the photo while keeping the layer mask exactly where it is. Make your photo active and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. If you're using CC 2019 or later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in, making sure the photo fills the shape of the layer mask. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Proceed to position and size it so it's cropped to your liking. Then press Enter or Return. More than likely, your photo will have areas brighter than the tone of the paper, which we wouldn't see if it was really printed on newsprint paper. There's a simple solution. Change the photo's blend mode to darken. This blend mode essentially replaces the lightest pixels of the photo with the lightest pixels of the paper. We'll convert our photo into a smart object so we can add filters to it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 15%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go back to Filter, Pixelate, and Color Halftone. The maximum radius is 4 pixels, and keep the screen angles at their default amounts of 108, 162, 90, and 45. Double-click the Blending Options icon next to Color Halftone and change its blend mode to Soft Light and its opacity to 60%. Since the darkest tones in newspaper printing are never true black, we'll lighten the darkest tones of our photo. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. Adjustment layers always affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. So, if we wanted to affect just the one layer below it, we need to clip them or restrict them to that one layer. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon, or you can go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Drag the contrast slider all the way to the left, or you can type in minus 50. Next, we'll add a texture that replicates the look of uneven ink distribution commonly seen in newspaper printing. Make a new layer. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Control or Command click the photo to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the clouds. This confines the clouds to the photo. Make the clouds active and change its blend mode to soft light and reduce its opacity to 40%. Next, we'll reduce the color's vibrancy a bit. click the adjustment layer icon, and click Vibrance. In this case, we don't have to clip the adjustment layer since the layers below our photo are monochromatic, so they won't be affected. I'll make the vibrance minus 20, but feel free to adjust the amount depending on the intensity of the colors in your photo. Next, we'll replace the text. Double-click the thumbnail of the text layer to open its source. We have four layers. Starting from the top, we have the day, the date, and the year, the headline, the secondary headline, and at the bottom, we have text that describes what's happening in the photo. After you install the fonts I provided, double-click the large T of the headline layer to highlight all its text. Click the box at the top to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in 1E three times. This gives us a similar dark gray color of the masthead. Type in your text. Double-click the secondary headline to highlight its text and type in new text. Click the top layer to make it active. Since the point size of this text is so small, we'll zoom into it by pressing Z to open your zoom tool and dragging it over that text. Double-click the large T of that layer to highlight the text and again type in the new day, date, and year. Make the bottom text active and press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit the page onto your canvas. Open your zoom tool and drag it over the bottom text. Double-click the large T to highlight the text and type in anything you'd like to describe the content of your photo. Then fit it back onto your canvas. To center all your text, shift-click the top layer to highlight all of them and press Ctrl or Command A and open your Move tool. Click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it. Close the tab of the text. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. We'll blur our text slightly so their edges blend in better. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.5 pixels. Lastly, we'll lighten our entire front page, which gives it a more naturalistic appearance. Make the vibrance layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Levels. In a nutshell, here's how Levels works. The input black and white levels determine what value is pure black and what value is pure white. The output black and white levels determine what color and tone should be used for the black point and the white point of the final image. In the output black field, type in 20. This essentially lightens the black tone into a dark gray. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.